Hey everybody, MagpieNightNine01 here, and this is the first 30 minutes of gameplay from Mafia 3. Purchased this game today, had high expectations for it, I still do, but if you've been following it then you'll know that it's been slated as another shitty console port. Now, the frame rate is locked to 30, which is really annoying. Yeah, give us an option to lock it to 30, but also give us an option to unlock it. You know, we're playing on, the vast majority of us will be playing on powerful rigs. So, again, poor decision on their part. Hopefully that'll be patched out and we will get unlocked frame rates soon. So far, I quite like the game though. The gameplay's good. The driving's a bit different. Obviously, I've been doing a lot of Forza 3 just lately, so going from that kind of driving into Mafia is a little bit different, but it's not bad. It's not Grand Theft Auto, but it's good. The combat system seems pretty good. Nothing out of the ordinary with your key setup or anything like that. So yeah, hopefully it's going to go on to be good, but it does need that patch to sort out the graphics. I mean, you know, we're not talking the Microsoft store here where they put out crappy games to start with and everything was locked and a lot of graphical options were missing. This is an established PC games maker, and they've given us this. So all I can think is that they've just decided to put it out at the same time as the console versions, and it's going to be patched out later, which, it's crap. It's a time this stopped, but it is what it is, and we have to live with it for now. But yeah, the game's good. Looks like it's got a lot of potential. The cutscenes, the graphics are amazing. The facial textures and the movement is really good. Some of the character modelling's a little bit out, but, you know, it's never going to be perfect, I suppose. But yeah, it's good. Anyway, enjoy the video. If you do stay towards the end, then leave some comments. Let me know what you think of the game. Have you purchased it? Are you thinking of purchasing it? Are you going to stay away until they've sorted out the options within it? So yeah, let me know. Anyway, enjoy. Please like or dislike if you want to, and subscribe, and I'll catch you in the next one. Take care.
In Delray Hollow, I can't say I approve, but often colored boys didn't have a lot of options back then. Boys like Lincoln, ones who've been abandoned, they're always looking for a home, always looking for a place to belong. I think he thought he'd find it in the army. Thing is, once that's lost, you can never get it back again. When he returned from the war, Lincoln ended back up over at Sammy's. Now Sammy owed the Italian mob a whole lot of money, and he needed Lincoln's help. It's a damn shame what happened. It breaks my heart.
Still say this is the craziest goddamn thing I ever heard. Using real money to rob the feds.
Well, hell, man, not like this is our cash. This all came from Skeletta. Besides, peanuts compared to what we're gonna haul out of there.
Is everything we need to burn?
Yeah, that's it. I grabbed the keys to the truck, then we can get the fuck out of here. He's in the other room. Grab him so we can get the hell out of here.
Still not sure about leaving him like this.
If you got doubts, why take the chance?
right then, that's that.
Goddamn.
We should get going. You got the keys, so you can drive.
Come on, let's get the hell out of here.
Take it easy heading to town. We don't need the cops crawling up our asses.
The old man wanted us to keep one of the guards alive, help throw the feds off the trail.
Like you said, I take a chance. Besides, if I learn anything from being over in Nam, someone's willing to flip sides once, they're probably willing to do it a second time. Fuck you in the process.
So answer me this. What's the craziest thing you saw over there?
You don't want to know.
Hell, man, I'm a taxpayer. I got the right to know how my money's being spent.
Oh, Georgie Marcano pays taxes.
Damn right I do. That's how they got Al Capone, and I ain't going to prison for no fucking tax bill. Huh. So come on, you going to answer the question or what?
Yeah. We're on the coast of Quang Nai, evacuating the civvies for Charlie overran everything. Anyway, we getting him onto a medical ship. This woman walks up. She's got a baby in one hand and the leash to a pig in the other. She starts up the ramp, and the MP stops her and tells her, you can only bring one thing on board. So she tosses the baby into the water. MP goes ape, tells someone dive in after the kid, starts screaming at the woman, wants to know what the fuck she's thinking. You know what she says to him? She says, I can always have another baby.
Jesus fucking Christ.
Hey, man, you asked.
Yeah, but I thought you were gonna tell me a story about some gook getting his dick blown off or something. I mean, god damn.
It's not a fault. But not like you think. The conditions over there, man. Jesus Christ. One day you're raising cattle, tending your rice. Next day everything bombed flat. You put people up against the wall, they will do anything to survive.
That better have been one delicious fucking pig.
Guards at the reserve probably won't be too keen on you waltzing around with that piece of yours.
I'll just leave it under the seat. Time to see if these forged IDs are worth a fuck.
Back it up to the loading dock.
Some of these fellas might get a little rough with the language and...
Well, ain't like I never been called nigger before.
I know, but I'm just saying, if I go along with it, ain't nothing personal.
The only thing I care about is getting our hands on that money.
Make our move.
All right.
Now, here we go.
Put your IDs up the glass.
We're part of the Boeing crew.
What the fuck's this shitheel doing here?
Affirmative action. You know how it is.
Old country is spinning around a goddamn toilet. You can follow me. As for you, go on and grab those bags off the truck. You'll be carrying them to the burning room. How much y'all bring in?
$238,546. Small bills, mostly.
I'll let Miss Gale call up your office when we're done. She'll confirm the delivery.
Appreciate it.
You need to check that scattergun. You packing anything?
Still in training.
Good. One less goddamn thing for me to worry about.
You can pick it up on the way out.
Buying rooms down in the cellar. This way. I ain't seen y'all around these parts before.
Y'all was over in Georgia for a while. He just got out the service.
And my cousin's been trying to get on here for over a year now. Was in the Navy for two tours, got medals falling out of his ass. Government tells him thanks, but no thanks.
That's a crock of shit if I ever heard one.
Sad day when a God-fearing white man can't get a job, but any old nigga who staggers in is hired on the spot. Bastards better not be playing with each other back there.
Fuck you! Christ, look at that. Didn't know y'all held that much gold.
That Washington's been shuffling around on account of the war. It's here, then it gets sent to Dallas, then it comes back. It doesn't make a lick of goddamn sense. Here we are.
Never done this detail before. Figured it'd be bigger.
I guess the job done. Only time there's a problem is when the flue clogs up.
Fuck, that's some heat right there.
Used to use coal for it, but a year or so back we switched over to oil. Maintains a more consistent flame.
I was trying to... God, that guy was an asshole.
We need to move. Danny and Ellis should be coming up any time now.
All right, give me a second. All right, you take care of those guards. Keep your ass down. You don't want them getting a drop on us.
I know what the fuck I'm doing.
sitting there. Called over there last night. Told them I wanted to sell. John starts laying into me, saying the lease gives them the right to a 30-day notice. That's how we supposed to find a new place in 2 weeks. So I tell him none of that's my goddamn... Come on, we need to get this vault open.
Oh, I hope this domination skeletor got us is legit. I'll be damned. All right, go for it, Godzilla.
Holy fucking shit.
It's beautiful. All right, I'm gonna take care of this room. You see what you can get from outside. Once these boys punch through with that drill, we're gonna start throwing this down.
The fucking alarm?
Shit, I didn't notice this cage was on a different system. All right, we're gonna hold off the guards until Danny's done drilling.
Hey, we're gonna pull this off.
Goddamn, we sure kicked the hornet's nest this time.
Only way we walk out of here is if we get the weapon stored in that armory. Bust the door open. I'll watch our asses.
Get a brick when he hears about... God damn it, why won't this open?
Give me that damn thing.
With the smoke!
Man, these guys ain't fucking around.
Faced way worse than this over in Nam. Little smoke don't mean shit. Stay close to the vault, watch for the drill. I'll deal with these assholes.
Well, Sammy had men all over the place. One of them worked at a cleaner's and stole the uniforms Georgie Marcano and Lincoln Clay wore on the day of the robbery. Another one was a janitor at the Federal Reserve, and he provided a rough layout. The robbery of the Federal Reserve was timed perfectly, and none of it would have been possible without the involvement of Sammy Robinson, Lincoln Clay, and the rest of the black mob.
You just come from Vietnam?
That's right.
I was a Marine in the Pacific. You take it from me. Just because you're home doesn't mean you're back. You understand? People around here, they don't get it. Never will. Keep your ass out of trouble.
I'm late. Got caught up crossing the bridge.
Don't worry about it.
Excuse me, sir. I'm looking for my stepbrother, Lincoln Clay. You seen him? He used to get ticked off if you were even a minute late.
Kiss my ass.
There he is. How was the trip?
Be as how this is the first time in 4 years and somebody telling me where to go, what to do, or how to do it. It was fucking great. What's new with the old man?
Man, don't even get me started on Pops. He used to pull his head out of his ass.
Same as ever then.
Brother, you have no fucking idea.
Damn, Ellis. She's looking good. Just like I left her.
Man, even I know not to fuck around with your car.
All right, come on. I'm ready to go home.
Sammy's doing all right.
Ever since we got your telegram about coming home, he's been climbing the walls. What if the plane crashes? What if the train's delayed? What if they call him back? And he goes stand in front of the kitchen window and sip his whiskey like he was expecting you to come strolling up the sidewalk. Don't say nothing about me telling you that.
I won't.
He'll be fine once he sees you. Ever since Mama Hell, you know how he gets. To Empire Bay a year or so after you shipped out. Started selling weed. They call and ask me if I want some. I say, sure. It's free money as far as I'm concerned. Anyhow, a month back, Marty drops me a line and says they're moving into heroin, that they're looking for a partner down around these parts.
Can't imagine Sammy was too keen on that.
I never told him about the weed. That ain't nothing to nobody. But this, I gotta talk to him about. I ain't said more than 3 words, and he's yelling about the feds. How we don't need J. Edgar up our asses, and what the fuck am I thinking? Selling dope with kids running around the neighborhood.
We ain't selling no dope to no children.
Like they got any money to begin with. Fucking around aside, that was pretty serious shit. Knew a couple guys over in Nam who were running it. Wound up pissing off the wrong person. Got their throats cut.
Shit, man, I know what's what. That's why I'm talking to Georgie about it.
There's no way Sal's gonna go along with that.
Georgie says he'd keep his old man from fighting out. We'll still clear the high-low in Frisco, just selling the French wall. Georgie's Uncle Lou won't say shit as long as we give him a taste of the action.
I don't know, man. George is a cool cat and all, but heroin ain't the kiddie pool.
Come in on it with us. I bet he'd agree to a three-way split.
I don't know. I kind of need to lay low a bit, figure some things out.
Yeah. All right. Going through the front. I ain't having your wall here, or I ask you the back door.
Look who I found panhandling out in front of the train station.
Pleasure, man.
Welcome back, baby. Boy, I send you to bring Lincoln Clayhorn. Not the big nigga who ate him.
Well, shit, old man. I finally went somewhere they knew how to cook.
Welcome home, son. How are you?
I'll be better once I get some of that shine in me.
I always did love gone whiskey. I would like to make a toast. My father used to say that the real worth of a man came from the mark he left on the world. When Lincoln first told me he was joining the military, I was against it. Too dangerous, I say. Let those people fight their own war, I say. But then I realized Lincoln needed to go out and make his mark. And that's precisely what he did. I'm so, so proud of you. Paul Lincoln, bienvenue à la maison.
Paul Lincoln, bienvenue à la maison.
Good to see you. You look so good.
Nice seeing you, Lincoln. Oh, I kept you in my prayers.
I really appreciate that, Father.
Now, who wants to get shit-faced? Woo!
It's hard to explain what it's like coming home from war. Elation. Fear. Guilt. Imagine being trapped in a dark room and there's no way out. And every fear, every nightmare you ever had is in that room with you. And there's no escape from any of it. And then one day a door opens and you're free to go. Just like that. The thing is, you made your peace with your terror and your fear of death. And now part of you is afraid to leave it behind. But what choice do you have? Every soldier has to walk through that door, one way or another.
Man, whiskey's going hoy in the morning.
Hell, man, just sleep it off. The room's the same as he left it.
I'm gonna take the basement.
The basement? Why the fuck you wanna crash down there?
I'll see you in the morning.
Man, that wall must have really fucked you up.